we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. And he's tackled at the 26-yard line.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 26-yard line. Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, gave a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
And that's three and out. Nothing going on that series. And they're coming after this punter. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. They'll certainly need better production from this offense as the game goes on.
Boy, the crowd was loud and did their part. Now if they're able to move the ball downfield, they can take control of this game early.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He's tackled at the 37-yard line.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really is nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
And he's immediately tackled.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
From the 49-yard line, first down. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback.
That makes it second and eight.
And they push him out at the 46. Third down and 7. Ball on the 46-yard line. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Complete. He's got room. Well, a new quarterback, but we saw this kid getting reps both in practice and in the pregame walkthrough, so this isn't a big surprise. Right around the 32-yard line.
That makes it second and 6.
From the 32-yard line, second down. Quick throw. He's pushed out of bounds at the 5.
Really difficult to cover somebody this fast. You can't stay with him in one-on-one coverage. And even when you double-team him, he still has the speed to beat you. You just have to hope that the timing is off between him and his quarterback.
This is the 8th play of this drive.
Mike Moore, Mike Moore.
he's scrambling. And he is drilled at the 7-yard line.
That brings up second and goal.
From the 7-yard line, second down. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Rifles it left, and it's incomplete. He led his wide receiver too far to the outside.
Yeah, he just had to pull the string a little bit more there.
It's fourth down. This should be an easy field goal. This to try to put his team up by a field goal. The kick is up, and it sails through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 34-yard line. The Panthers are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Gets out to about the 35-yard line. We've got a second and 9 here. Ball on the 35. Now he tries to buy some time. He picks up a good 7 yards there in the quarterback keeper. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's taken down right around the 46-yard line.
I think he just barely got it. That's a great job by both the quarterback and receiver to keep this drive alive.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Tackle made right around the 44-yard line. Loss of 2 on the run by the halfback. Hit out of bounds at the 47-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. There's a fumble, and they fall on the loose ball. So at the end of one, the Panthers lead 3-0. We're back for more action here in quarter number 2. In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. And here's the... Wait a minute, the upback's got it. They'll bring him down at the 48-yard line. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Quick strike, and he drops it. It's second and 10. Ball on the 48. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
So the sack makes this third and very long. And he tackles him hard at the 30-yard line.
Loss of 10 yards on the play. That makes it fourth and long.
Excellent punt. And down he goes at the 35. This defensive end has been a force, Kirk.
Well, this is the kind of guy that any defensive coach just loves. He's a tough guy. He's not afraid to mix it up. And he always seems to be around the football.
Well, all of his good plays have added up to his team enjoying the lead. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Set, Oklahoma.
They hand it off. Nice run to the left there.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That brings them second and five.
From their own 40-yard line. Second down. Throws this one away. And they got him.
He has one job on passing situations. Get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
And this one is a beauty. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Keeps a foot in and pulls it down.
Here's a great example of what this man is capable of. As receivers go, he's as electric as they come.
First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. He's taken down at the 41. Second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Tackle around the 39-yard line.
He had nowhere to go on that option play.
Boy, you're right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
The catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit. It's up, and he splits the uprights. Like they're ready for the kick.
He's out to the 30. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. The offense calls a timeout, and they've got two remaining. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And down he goes at about the 41. Kirk, we saw this guy head to the locker room a little bit earlier. Good to see him back on the sideline, and it looks like he could be returning to the game. He makes it to the 42-yard line.
I think the play call was the right one by the offense. I just think the defense made a better play. They seem to want it more here on this big third down. Offense comes up a little bit short to set up a fourth down, but give all the credit to the personnel on the defensive side of the ball.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
Both offenses have played it pretty close to the vest so far in this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Those completely stopped immediately. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. They'll bring him down at the 33. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Quick throw out to the receiver. Right down at the 45-yard line. 5 wide. And it's caught. He's at the 40, and he hits him hard at the 38-yard line. Intercepted.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 38. He chucks it downfield. Looking for 6, and he got it. Touchdown. The extra point. It was a 7-play, 79-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
So the score now, 13-0. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt. Steps out of bounds around the 27-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on the 27. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. And he's finally taken down at the 41-yard line. And he busted that one wide open.
On defense, you can't afford to give up big runs like that.
Fires it out. And he's tackled in the open field.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
Pulls it in and gets out of bounds.
That's a gain of seven. First down.
The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. Kicks away, and he just drilled it from long range. They line up to kick this one away. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line. As they head to the locker rooms, this one is far from over. The Panthers with a 10-point lead.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. Going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He's out to the 30. He's tackled at the 41-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Gives it to the back. And he's tackled at the 40-yard line.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
From their own 40-yard line, second down. Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled around the 41-yard line. Toss. And they make the stop at the 25. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. First and 10. Ball on the 14. And they'll get him in the backfield.
That'll bring up second and 12.
Makes it to the 15-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that long.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's taken down around the 29-yard line.
Gain 8 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 6.
Nice play fake. He's going to go for the home run. And that'll make it 4th down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
That'll make it 4th and 6.
The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a deep 5 on the way. That brings up 2nd and 5.
It's 2nd down, 5 to go. Ball on the 41.
Mike four. There.
Tackle made around the 42-yard line.
Number 7 brings him down to the 42-yard line. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on 3rd down. Steps up around the 43-yard line.
Gain of 1 yard. That brings up 4th and 3.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Makes it to the 22-yard line. Defense shut him down on their last drive, forcing a quick punt.
Down 2 possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Run. Taken down as he works the left for a nice game.
That's a deep 6 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 8.
2nd down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the 1st down.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
1st down.
Double tight. Mike four.
Up the middle for a nice game.
That's a deep 4. That makes it 2nd and 6.
It's 2nd down, 6 yards to go. Ball on their own 47. He makes it out to midfield. That's three down and one to go. The Panthers with a 13-point lead. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. He's at the 40. Makes it out to about the 36.
That's good for a gain of 14 yards.
First down. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. On the ground with the tailback. He makes his way to about the 28.
That's a gain of 1 play. That makes it second and two.
Two times.
He's at the 20.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs is pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
He gets out to about the 15-yard line.
That makes it second.
It's the ninth play of the drive. The 10. Touchdown. Well-designed play to get the halfback into the end zone.
Hey, for this guy, it doesn't matter how it's drawn up. He can make his own play as he goes along. That was a nice run.
He makes the PAT. A 9-play, 77-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
He really got a hold of that kick. And they can forget about returning this one. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. He makes his way out to about the 35.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
From their own 35-yard line, it's first down. And now he's got room to run, and he's taken down at the 44.
That brings up second and one.
Complete over the middle. Tackle at the 49. From the 49-yard line, first down. Just under three to go in regulation. Across the middle, caught, and down he goes at the 41.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
Watch the slant. Motion.
In incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Nice pitch and catch for the first down. He's pushed out of bounds at the 33. The defense calls a timeout. And now they've only got one remaining. Five wide. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 29-yard line.
That brings him second and five.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Brought down at the 28-yard line. A one-yard gain by the halfback. Third down again. The defense calls a timeout. And that was their third and final timeout. Just under 2 minutes in the game. They bring him down.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see. Your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Kicks up. No good. He missed it to the right. Here we are late in the fourth quarter, and this is what this game has come down to. Every possession is going to count, and this could be the one right here. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Out of bounds at the 42. From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he tackles him hard at the 49-yard line.
Number eight with the tackle at the 49-yard line. That'll make it third and one.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throws it in a hurry. To the 20, the 10, and we're all tied up. Thank you.
trying to take the lead. Here's the extra point.
The offense didn't get the playoff in time.
Delayed game. Offense.
Under a minute left in the game.
And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
It's been a good one so far today. Let's see what happens here.
There's no need to do anything drastic here. They are behind, but all they need is a field goal.
Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. Tackle made
right around the 32-yard line.
Knocked out of bounds
around the 44-yard line. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 17-16. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.